Hello YouTube! In this tutorial, let me show you how to build a voice chatbot with Python and a ChatGPT API. Before I get started, let me show you how it works. This is a Python script which calls the OpenAI's ChatGPT API and then interact with API for users' requests. At first, I will run this code. Jack! How long does it take to fly from San Francisco to San Diego?
The average flight duration from San Francisco to San Diego is around 1 hour and 20 minutes. However, this time can vary depending on factors such as airline, weather conditions, and air traffic.
How about driving?
The driving distance from San Francisco to San Diego is approximately 500 miles, and the driving time can vary depending on traffic and the chosen route. On average, the drive takes around 8 to 9 hours, but it can take longer during peak traffic hours, or if there are any traffic congestions along the way.
That's all for today. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Bye now.
Okay, you get the idea. So this voice chatbot can interact with the user. So let's see how can we build this. At first, I'd like to talk about the motivation for this tutorial because recently, the OpenAI Python API library has been rewritten in the version 1, which was released in November. Most of the existing tutorials online have been using the old API function names, which no longer work. For example, if you use force two function names, the code will no longer work. The new version becomes like this. Let's see how the Python script works. Before that, I will talk about some requirements and to set a system environment variables. At first, we need a computer, speaker, and microphone. And then we need a software, Python 3.10 or newer, with additional packages. I will list the packages needed for this Python script in the description below. I also use Visual Studio to develop this code. You can use other programs as well. The third thing we need is OpenAI API key. I will show you how to get this from the OpenAI website. At first, you need to log in to your OpenAI account. Once you log in, you will see this page. From here, you click API. And on the left-hand side, click API keys. And then click this button here to create a new key. You can give this any name you like and then create a new key here. I already did this before, so I don't need another key anymore. Once you have this key, what you need to do is to add this key as a system environment variable. So on Windows machine, normally what you do is you start from here, right click this PC and click properties. After that, this window shows up. And from here, you click Advanced System Settings. In this new window, you click Environmental Variables. You can add environmental variables from here. Next time, you can start writing the program. So here is the program I wrote before. At first, we import some packages like speech recognition package, OpenAI package, text-to-speech package, audio packages. This is also another audio package. In the beginning, we initialize the Py game package for playing the MP3 files. And then we create OpenAI client. And then we get the date of today. And this is used in the name of the log file. Again, over here, we initialize the text-to-speech package. And we set a speaking rate. So the higher this number, the faster the computer will speak. In a demonstration earlier, I used another package. I will talk about this later. You can also change the voice to male or female. 0 is male, 1 here is female. So this is for Python text-to-speech package. So over here, I define a function, chat function here. This function calls the OpenAI API with this function name. Maximum token here is the length of the response from the ChatGPT. And a talk here is a dictionary data type which stores the user question and AI's response. And over here, I defined a variable to turn on or off the OpenAI text-to-speech engine. I have two methods. One is to use the OpenAI text-to-speech engine. The other one is to use the Python text-to-speech engine. So by default, this is on. The thing is, if you use this OpenAI's text-to-speech engine, this also costs money, because when you sign up for the OpenAI account, they give you $5. As you can see here, I have already used the $1.27. But if you use the Python version here, it's free. So to use this text-to-speech engine, what you do here is you also have to create a function here. And over here, you can change whether to use a male or female voice. Over here, I'm using the female voice. OpenAI's engine will create a MP3 file. So then we play this MP3 file with this Pygame mixer. If we don't use the OpenAI's text-to-speech engine, we can use the Python text-to-speech engine, which will be like this. It's much easier and it's free. As I mentioned earlier, this talk is a dictionary data type which stores the conversation. This function here is just to add the conversation to a text file. Here is our main function, which calls all the other functions. Let's see how it works. I defined a speech recognition variable here, and the second one here is a microphone, and we turn off the dynamic energy threshold. Instead, we define an energy threshold to be 400, which works well in a quiet room. And then I define a variable called sleeping, which equals true in the beginning. So this while loop is always true, so which means this loop is always running. To begin with, we start with a microphone and we adjust the microphone settings for the ambient noise for 1 second. And then we print this message listening, which you have seen in the beginning of the video. And then we will listen to the user's request, and then we convert that request from audio to a text. If the user's first request has the word Jack, the computer will now wake up and sleeping will be off, and the user will start talking to the computer. And the questions after the word Jack will be the request sending to ChatGPT. So if the sleeping is false, which means the computer is no longer sleeping, and we will just take the message from the user. So the second question a user asks does not have to include in the word Jack anymore. If the user said that's all, and then that will be the end of the conversation, the computer will go back to sleep. So if we receive a request from the user, at first we will save the request into a log file, and then we will echo this question back to the user. From there, we will send the request to ChatGPT and get a response from ChatGPT. So once we receive the response, we add this response to our log file, and the computer will speak back this response to the user. So as you can see, this is entire program. Hi, Jack, who are you?
I am an AI, artificial intelligence, developed by OpenAI. I am designed to assist and provide information to users like yourself. How can I assist you today?
Please check our GitHub page for the Python code and detailed instruction on how to install Python packages required for the program. And if you have any questions and requests, please leave in the comments section below. I will get back to you as soon as possible. I hope you enjoyed this video. See you next time. Bye-bye.